Hello, good day. This is Rachel from IPASS Processing and welcome back to our YouTube channel. If you are new in this YouTube channel, IPASS Processing is a processing agency as well as it's a service provider providing NCLEX online review program and NCLEX Australia and NCLEX Canada. So for the services that we are offering to our clients, kindly click the description down below. In this video, we are going to talk about the latest modification on your NCLEX-RN examination, which I have received in news coming from NSBN last night. Actually, it was midnight that I received that certain communication, and I think you also received that one in your inbox. So it's like being widely discussed as of this time because there will already be changes again to the current NCLEX examination experience by examinees. So I'm going to point out the original NCLEX examination, the first modification, and the next modification, which will be starting on October 1, 2020. So prior to COVID, that was the original NCLEX. There was no modification, and then COVID came. So there were a lot of cancellation for the examination, a lot of reschedulings, and then NCSBN modified the NCLEX, and it started last March 25, 2020 for the implementation of that first modification. And then last week, actually, I received an inquiry from one of our clients as well asking me if that certain modification for the current NCLEX as of this time will be extended for another month. And I told him that actually I didn't know if it will be extended or not because it's actually the discretion of the NCSBN. They are the ones deciding whether they're going to extend it or not or to make any changes regarding to the modification. So now this is the latest update for your NCLEX examination. So let's first start with the original NCLEX examination. So for the original examination, let's first start with the number of items. As to the number of items, that was 75 minimum and the maximum number was 265. So during this time and up until September 30, 2020, they removed the 15 items of the pretest, making it at least 60 items for the minimum number, and the maximum number will be 130 items. And starting October 1, it will already be back to 75 items for the minimum number. And then instead of 130 items for the maximum number, it will be 145 because of course they have added the 15 items which were pre-test items. Now let's move forward to the pre-test items. So for the original examination, there were 15 items which were pre-test items in your actual examination. You cannot identify whether this particular number is a pre-test item or not a pre-test because there's no identification in there during the actual examination that this is a pre-test. And those pre-test items were actually not scored. You will be able to experience that because the original one was 75, but then those items, the pre-test items, were not scored. So the purpose of having the pre-test items is that they are using those pre-test items for the next revisions on their Q bank, and also they're going to use that one as part of their research as to if this certain number or the certain item will be applicable for the next revisions or not. I'm so sorry for the dog because the dogs are playing here. I'm so sorry for that. So the pre-test items were not included on the current examination as of this time because you are just going to experience the 60 items. They removed the 15 items pre-test which were not scored. So there's no problem because actually that's not part of the examination because it's not scored. So it's just fine that they removed that one, making it at least 60 items. Now, by October 1, 2020, they're going to introduce again the pre-test items, which will be 15 items again. So the same as the original one, that it will be 75 items minimum, and maximum items will be 145 items because there will be pre-test items. Now, moving forward to the number of maximum hours that you can experience during your examination. So in the original examination, you have at most 6 hours for the total number of maximum time. That was really a lot, right? But because you are going to answer 265 maximum items, so you have 6 hours. Now, in the current examination until September 30, you will have 4 hours for the total examination. So by October 1, 2020, it will be 5 hours. So 6 hours and then 4 hours, and then now they are going to give you again another 1 hour because they have included 15 items for the pre-test. So there were a lot of questions about, is it better that it's 5 hours or 4 hours comparing with the original examination, which was 6 hours. Actually, the advantage that I can only see in there is that you will finish early in your examination, because whether you like it or not, it's going to end if you have already reached or if you have consumed the total 4 hours or the 5 hours. So instead of experiencing a prolonged time of having hypoglycemia because you are already tired and you cannot think anymore, so you have lesser time to finish your examination. So let's now move forward to the run out of time rule during your NCLEX examination. So originally, there was a rule or there are criteria that they are implementing and they are using if ever that you are going to run out of time. And the following criteria was previously used. If ever that you have not reached the maximum number of items, that was 265, and you run out of time, and the computer has not decided yet whether your performance was above the passing standard or below the passing standard, then they're going to use this one. If you have not answered at least 75 items, then your result will be failed. And if ever that you have answered at least 75 items or beyond the minimum number of items, which was 75 previously, then they're going to use this one. They're going to go back to the last 60 items and they're going to check the last 60 items. And if your performance was above the passing standard, so you are going to pass the NCLEX. If upon checking the last 60 items and there was just a drop in your performance below the passing standard, even just one drop on your performance and it was below the passing standard, then you are also going to fail your examination. But if your performance was all above the passing standard for the last 60 items, then you are going to pass your examination. So for the current examination, which will be until September 30, 2020, I don't know if that's applicable still because NCSBN didn't mention that on their first modification, but by October 1, 2020, they said that it's no longer applicable. The one that I have discussed to you earlier, it's no longer applicable because they're going to check all the number of items that you have completed for your examination, and by then they are going to assess there whether your performance was above the passing standard or below the passing standard. If you are clueless about the passing standard, simply the explanation for the passing standard is your minimum standard. Yeah, minimum standard, minimum criteria for you to be considered a safe nurse as an entry level nurse. That's the simplest explanation regarding the passing standard. So another thing that they have also pointed out was the NGN research session. NGN starts for next generation research questions, because as you might have experienced already, for those who already took the examination and those who had enough time for their examination on their remaining time, so they were able to experience the next generation research questions. Prior to having the research questions, you can see a prompt in your computer screen telling you that this certain part will already be part of the research questions and it will not be scored. It is not a must for you to answer those research questions, and also it's just voluntary. So whether you want to include that or you want to answer those research questions, it's fine. If you don't want to answer those research questions, then it's also fine. So but it is encouraged by NCSBN to answer those research questions because those questions will be used for their research purposes, as the name describes. So they're going to use that one, whether this particular questions will be applicable for the next revisions on their examination. And also, the next generation NCLEX research questions will have different types of questions during your NCLEX. But you don't worry about this next generation NCLEX because this will only be applicable and it will be implemented by 2023. So it's not now, not earlier than 2023 as NCSBN has pointed out. So also, you have to remember that not all examinees will be able to experience the research questions because research questions will only be delivered to examinees who still have the remaining time for their NCLEX. Because if you just have like 10 minutes or 5 minutes, so you will not be able to participate the research questions. So only those examinees who still have enough time to answer that will be able to experience the research questions. So the last thing that they have pointed out on their latest modification is about the NCLEX tutorial. This NCLEX tutorial, actually you can see this one in NCSBN's website. You just have to type NCLEX tutorial and you will be able to experience how the actual computer screen will look like on your actual examination. At least you will have a feel of how it will look like. Also included in there will be like types of items in your examination and then how are you going to answer those specific questions. So in the upcoming October 1, 2020, NCSBN said that for the NCLEX tutorial, they have changed that one from a general rule, they have changed it to a guide and test taking tips. So those are the differences and comparison between the original NCLEX, the first modification, and the upcoming modification, which will be implemented by October 1, 2020. So in the next video that I'm going to discuss with you, we will be talking about what are the implications for the latest modification. Is it better now than the original one or the first modification? And what are also the questions of the upcoming test takers? So we are going now to move on to the next video. So this video will be up to here. Bye for now and see you on the next video.